We'd like to introduce you to Phil Ortley, who's worked in agriculture for 50 years as a grower, packer, and shipper of citrus. He's been working organically for 30 years. It was 8 years ago that Vermisterra saved his sick and dying trees. He since shared the power of Vermisterra worm castings and nutrient tea with his friends and neighboring organic farms. Let's hear his testimony.
Well, we had 20 acres of grapefruit on rough lemon, which is susceptible to Phytophthora. And we definitely had an outbreak of Phytophthora, which at the time we attempted to remedy the problem, we probably lost 20% of the grove, and another 20% was infected with Phytophthora, which we would have lost those. But when we started using the Vermisterra earthworm casting tea, within a year we saw a reversal in the decline of the tree, and within a year and a half the tree had made a complete comeback, and after 2 years the trees were 100% back, and we didn't lose another tree after that, and in fact increased the productivity of all the trees that were in the grove.
It's a little fly. That's a little fly. So it's a silly.
So what they're trying to do is stop the bug from spreading it. It leaves the disease. It goes down into the root system and hibernate. When the tree gets stressed, then it'll come back up into the tree, and that's when it'll get the disease. So if you keep the tree healthy, real healthy, it's going to resist the disease. It may have it, and they're working on a way to detect it. They're not quite there yet, whether the tree actually is infected or not. You can't really kill them until it's already become severe. Then they can detect it. They spray a lot, either by airplane or by ground rig, periodic program to control that from spreading. And they've learned this from the experience they had in Florida, which basically that disease basically wiped out them.
The citrus people are very skeptical of what it'll do. They don't listen to us, farmers. I had a disease called Phytophthora in 30 acres of grapefruit. And when I started using the tea, within 2 years, we completely eradicated it. And we know the reasons why and all that. But to try, there's a grower just right down the road. I can show you his grove. He's got a major infestation of Phytophthora. I can't get it through to him that use a tea and you don't, and he goes in and puts, well, it's called Bordeaux mix on. They open up the tree, they go in and they put this stuff on the tree. And, but the disease is spreading to all the other trees. We tell them, but they don't listen. They don't think I know what I'm talking about. And he got the disease because I had the grove right across the street from him. That's where he got the disease from. But I stopped it.
Yeah. Anthony Farms sells to Whole Foods. And they've been using it 5 years here?
Yeah.
So these are 5-year-old trees?
Yeah.
Oh, they're huge.
Yeah, that's what's so amazing about the whole thing. They'd be 3 feet taller just if they pruned them about a month ago. See, you're dealing with two mindsets in farming. You've got the old traditional chemical, go by what the universities recommend and all that, and then you've got the new organic microbes and stuff that will kill the bacteria which caused the disease.
So you feel good about what you're doing then? You're saving the trees.
I'd rather be 50.
Largest mango grower in California.
Also the mangoes across the street, that's another 40 acres that get the same stuff.
Wow.
Theft, big time theft. This is big money. Fuck a mango.
Oh, we thought it was to keep wild animals out.
Well, Yeah, two-legged walleye. No, it's a high theft.